Okay, YouTube, here are the components for a wastewater burner. This is actually very easy to make. You know, you can put it together fairly quickly. This is 1-inch pipe. Let me see if you can see that tape. You know, inch internal diameter pipe. I don't know, in millimeters it's 34 mil or something. External diameter. Okay, so here's what I have. I have a piece of pipe. This is a piece of pipe. With a 22.5 degree cut on it. This, the angle of this thing, can you see it? That angle, 22.5 degrees. Because what I want to do is I want to bisect a 45 degree angle. You'll see why in a minute. Okay, so that's 7 inches long. Okay, 7 inches with a 22.5 degree cut on it. This guy here, I'm actually not sure what that is. It's about just over 2 inches. I don't know, in millimeters, it's about 55 millimeters. Long end, and it's again 22.5 degree cut. Okay, and this one has an elbow on it. Okay, a mild steel elbow, threaded internally, and it's got a hole. You can see right away through it. I drilled that hole in there, and the hole is big enough for this half inch pipe to go through. So that's I'm going to show you how I assemble this. So here we go. There's the bit of pipe with a 1-inch gun barrel elbow on it. So the length of pipe to the end of the thread and the elbow is, I don't know, ballpark 6.25 inches, or about 160 millimeters. Something like that. It's not mission critical, you know, it just needs to be. I've measured this so that it goes to the center of my propane tank, which is what I'm going to use now. So here we go. Look, see if you can see this. This is the half inch pipe with a 90 degree bend on it. And the deal is, I want pipe in a pipe. Okay, so that's why I've drilled the elbow, you know, with a hole slightly bigger than the pipe so that the pipe easily goes through it. Okay. This is why we've got this double 22.5 degree piece. What I want to do is I want to make a bend, okay? And I want no joints in this half inch pipe. This half inch pipe is the oil line, and I want it to travel straight through that 1-inch pipe without coming into contact with the flame, and the air kind of cools it down. So here's my 7-inch piece, and you can see that all these angles make a 90 degree bend. Okay, so the oil comes out that half inch pipe, okay, and the air comes out the space around it. So it's like a little blower. The air comes out around the pipe and oil just travels down the half inch copper pipe. At no time is the half-inch copper pipe pressurized, or the air doesn't come in contact with what's in it. It's just the fact that the air travels down the around that copper pipe, it keeps the pipe cool and stops the oil cooking as it travels down it into the fire. So that's it. This 1-inch opening here, that gets air. Air, I'm going to put a connector on that, and I'm going to connect it up to a blower. So air blows in here, goes round the corner, down this tube, and out here. And that's going to provide the oxygen necessary for combustion. And the half-inch copper pipe is going to provide the fuel for the combustion. So very easy. Alright, so what I've done is I've welded that on. And it's in the right position with the holes in the right place to suit the propane tank that I've got. Okay, so again, pipe in a pipe. But what I don't want, if I can help it, I don't want that pipe touching the sidewalls of the 1-inch pipe, because they get very hot. So what I've done is I've made a kind of a spring. This is just mild steel galvanized fence wire, and I've just wrapped it around the half inch pipe. But as I got to the end, this end, I made it wider. So okay, so what's going to happen now is, let's see if I can do it. I'm going to stick that on, if I can. Let me see. Okay. Alright, so what can you see? You can see that it's holding the pipe away, and as the more I get into it, I'll have to do it off camera because I need two hands for it. But anyway, that's what it's going to do. It's going to hold that half-inch pipe in the center of the one-inch pipe. I don't think it'll affect the airflow because the air will get around it anyway. And so that's what we have. We have half-inch pipe going straight down the center of that one-inch pipe and getting to there. Okay, so just give me a second. Okay, what I'll do is I'll mock it up now so that you can see what's going on. So there's the half-inch, the half-inch pipe in the center, that one-inch pipe. There's the whole kind of burner unit, if you like, which is no more than just a bit of a pipe with a bend on it. I've already drilled a 44mm hole in this thing, as I showed a little earlier. This thing goes through it, and then you can see the fit. Okay, so let's see. It's a nice tight fit, all the way around, no gap. So it wouldn't matter anyway if it was a little bit sloppy, because air would just end up going being sucked in by the fire into it. So okay, so I've already pre-drilled that hole, and what I'm going to do, sorry about this, is just put the screws in it. So these are self-drilling tech screws, and I've already pre-drilled this. So if I can maneuver this with one hand, maybe I can do it. Okay, so let's see. Okay, and that's it. There's my pipe. This is going to be my inlet, where my thumb is, in through this one-inch elbow, and the oil line is this half-inch pipe. And my spring has fallen out, but I'm going to fix that off camera. So there's where the old burner unit used to go through. You can see my hand. And all I'm going to do is this part is going to sit over that hole. I'll try it anyway. If I need to modify it, I will. We've got about a 2-inch gap between, or 1.5-inch gap between the bottom of this pipe and the floor of the pot. And if it burns well at that, I'll leave it at that. On the previous one I did, I had about a 2-inch gap. So that's the setup. It just goes through the sidewall of the stove or propane tank and comes out there. I'm going to plumb it up.
Okay, so here
now.
We are. I said I'd do the plumbing and I'd show how it's done. So here we go. This is just some stuff I had lying around. This is it's not soldered, but it's a solder elbow for inch copper. Some inch copper into a fitting into that elbow. So that's just my air intake blowing up this 1-inch copper pipe. This half inch tube into that elbow is one piece all the way down to the end. I don't know if you can see it, it's very black in there. In any case, maybe we'll see it when I fire it up. But that's the setup. The oil drops through this T-piece, through that gate valve, drops straight down, gets into this half-inch pipe, and that's the oil line, with no interference, all the way down, across, and down into the actual stove. This is the original propane tank conversion that I did with the other burner. That particular burner works without any power; it just works on a gravity feed of oil into it, and hot air rising creates enough suction to mix the fuel. So in any case, what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to leave a bit of a gap. It's just a disc. I'm going to leave a bit of a gap so that if I do open the bottom door, if I want to throw in any extra air, it can come up through here and get into the burn chamber. I'll show that in a second. So I'm going to put the pot. So the pot just tips under the, it's about 2 inches from the base of that pipe to the deck, you know, to the bottom of that burn chamber. The pot just scoops it under. So the plan is the pot's slightly off center. Doesn't matter. I mean, you can move it around when it's firing. You just wouldn't do it with your hand, you know. And in any case, there is the pot's in there.
There's the feed. That 1-inch pipe is the feed in into that elbow, and into the back of the elbow is the eye line. It's going to become apparent now in a second. So if I open this gate valve, maybe we can see. Let's give it a shot. There we go. You can see the oil. And when the oil goes in, let's see. It should appear in here. Once, there we go. Okay, so that's oil in. Now I opened it a bit, quite a bit there. And that goes in, and that's what actually burns. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to see if I can set this up. Let's try that. Okay, so I'm not sure how this is going to work out, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to put, this is some kerosene. You know, I don't know how much that is, but a drop. And I'm going to pour that into the pot. I didn't mean to put it all in, but it's all in now, so it doesn't matter. Turbo torch, and I'm going to actually light it. So here we go. Let's get the kerosene hot enough to burn. There we go, it's kind of going on its own. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to plug in the burner or the blower. And you can see it has an instant effect on it. Okay, so this is with the door open. And you can see that pipe now. That pipe is an inch off the floor of that pot. And I close the door now. Okay, so that's it burning. I don't know, it's a bit bright, it seems, for the camera. However, there's the plumbing there. Little bit of a gap around it. And in operation, that gap actually expands. It's already getting bigger. And let's put our fuel in. Okay, so I think that's the conclusion of this video. What I'll do is I'll do another video of it running, and I need to do some stuff to it now. So anyway, if you found any of this helpful, maybe you could like, comment or subscribe. Anyway, that's it. One successful waste oil burner, and in the next video I'll show it running, temperatures and all that sort of stuff. Thanks very much. Bye.